Cats have often been seen as our furry friends, but with the rise of the internet, cats are seeing their culture being appropriated by humans. Cat ears, cat sounds, and even wild cat prints all now have a different meaning than what it means to our feline kind.
You can be free.
Hello, my name is Marlene, and welcome back to another episode of Inappropriate Appropriation. On this week's episode, we take a look at the disturbing new trends in social media and their unlikely victims.
Yes, the Felis catus, or domestic cat, I think is what they're called and what most people call them. Yeah. In popular media, they're the most common of the animals to be depicted, which I find really fascinating, but it's just gotten more problematic over the years. Now I see older human women dressed in animal print, and they say, like, not the women themselves, obviously, but the judges or, like, other people looking at them, they see them as tacky and overly sexual, and that's a little bit unnerving and not nice to think about.
I think she is a menopausal kitten. I think she looks great. That dress says, I'm not dead yet.
You walk the runway that you have a little bit more of a spunky personality. You're a little sassy. From a fashion point of view, though, I do not like it.
I mean, what if your skin was suddenly seen as overly sexual or tacky and you don't want to be? That'd be terrible.
So what are those cat ears about?
Funny you should mention the ears. I spent the last 7 years of my life studying under the chieftain of this feline village that was on the other side of the continent. It was very interesting at the time because I was studying rituals and rites of passage, and for the longest time I studied with the chief, and he was very impressed with my studies, so he bestowed onto me these ears, and I was overjoyed because now I'm an honorary cat.
Meow, 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 meow. Meow, meow, meow. Meow, 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 meow. Meow.
At the turn of the 20th century, actually, cats have been historically turned into cartoons, caricaturized. You always see cats with large ears, for example, and this is sort of very unsettling because they were made fun of for their ears, but now it's become sort of an aesthetic taste or an attractive marker for young women. Feline features, all of these were sort of became sexualized in culture, and it's unnerving because cats use their ears to hear. They're for hearing, they're not for decoration, and they're born with them.
So what can people do about this problem?
Oh, that's not too difficult. Just be very kind and understanding to cats. Be open, welcoming of their cultures. Don't push too far. If a cat, for example, is very stressed out when you do things to them or take parts of them and take it as your own, just stop. Just stop. Ask your cat. Ask any cat, actually, if they're okay with it. And eventually you will come to understand what is all right and what is not all right. It's a very sensitive issue, so do take care. Treat cats as agents of culture and heritage.
Will the problem of cat appropriation continue in the future? The answer depends on a variety of factors that are all intertwined. We can only hope that future generations think twice before perpetuating this problem so that we can continue to make an environment that is safe and accepting for both humans and cats. Join us next week when we look at the cultural appropriation of unicorns. My name is Marlene De Vera. Good night.